Women's Day is basically honoring and acknowledging and celebrating all the achievements all of the women around us and across the globe. So today specifically is a day that we acknowledge the beautiful women who have been a part of our journey in our lives and how they have been responsible in taking us where we are today. So it is a celebration and devoted day for women especially. Also, I think so we should, it should not be a celebration for one day. It should be generically acknowledged for all the sacrifices and the efforts women in our lives, be it in a capacity of a mother or a mentor or a mother or a friend or sister, in whatever capacity we have women in our lives. I think so we should acknowledge the efforts of everybody around us and how they've contributed in our lives.
हम आमतौर पर देखते हैं कि women's day पर हम gender equality की बात करते हैं, generation equality की बात कर रहे हैं. इस साल का जो theme है, वो generation equality के ऊपर है. तो what's your take on that? Because generation equality is what about all is all about gender, then caste, religions. What's your take on that?
I think so. Generation equality is again. Bringing together different people of different castes, religion, gender, age all together to drive in an action to create a gender equality world that we all thrive to live in. So I think so this is all what generation equality is, and withstanding with that, I think so everybody should make an effort of not being so obsolete in their thoughts and creating disparities on the basis of religion or age or gender or a color or nationality for that matter. I think so every individual is unique and every individual is you know, at par with anybody else. So not just a religion or a color can make them any inferior or superior, in my opinion.
कभी ऐसा आपके साथ हुआ है कि आपने कभी discrimination face किया हो या फिर आपने
Not such a harsh discrimination, but yes, I think so. Being raised up in a society that is so conditioned of a male-dominated society, I think so we all face a little discrimination in probably aspects of our life, different aspects of our life. For example, to say in our industry. It is, I think so, such a hero, such an actor dominated industry that there's a difference in, I think so, the pay of how a male actor is paid as opposed to a female actor. Primarily because maybe the scripts are more of a hero protagonists, or it is just maybe the conditioning or maybe just the ideology and thoughts that an actor has to be paid more because his contribution to the industry is more than a female actress, which is actually not true. So yes, there is few discrimination according to that. Also, I think so, even as in terms of opportunities, there's a little difference. There is a difference of opportunities between gender and on the basis of how every gender is also given offered roles or offered jobs according to just on the basis of he's a man and she's a woman. I think so there is a disparity of that.
Okay. Have you ever, like, in your personal life, have you ever faced anything like that?
Yeah, as I spoke about the pay disparity, there is a pay disparity. There is a difference, there is an inequality in the opportunities also of a man and a woman. So I think so, not majorly, not so harshly, but I think so I have faced such discriminations. But I think so that's the society we all have been raised in, and yeah, pretty much.
Okay. And if we talk about how do you celebrate Women's Day?
I don't think so. To celebrate a woman, you need just a day for that to celebrate. Yes, I'm feeling like a woman today. I think so. It is a blessing to be a woman, and it women are less known for the sacrifices they make and the contributions they've made to the society, and all the courage they equip. So I think so. We should not let anybody direct us to what we ought to do in life or not, and we should just celebrate being women every day and celebrate being us.
Do you think the mindset of the society has been changed according to you? Is there any awareness that has been impact on the male dominated society?
Definitely, like as if you go back then when I think so we've thankfully I have been born in a time when conditions are not so staunch and are not so hard hitting. But as we've read, like how back then in the day, women were just merely restricted and towards the kitchen or just for the household work. I think so. It has changed considerably to that. A lot of women are being recognized and have been honored for the achievements they've made to the society. And yes, of course, there is a lot of awareness. I think so because people have started talking about it. People have started acknowledging it. So I think so there is a difference. And also talking about our industry with the Me Too movement, I think so it has, not just our industry, anywhere. I think so it has just given a lot of courage to the women and has given a voice to all the girls, ladies out there to just talk about and not being ashamed of being attacked or being molested or being down upon, suppressed in any way. I mean, a lot of women might have faced all these things and in fact, the thing, maybe it's their fault that they are women and they cannot talk about it. So a lot of women did not have the courage to come out and speak out their truth. So I think so with the awareness and how everybody's come together, I think so, and with the Me Too movement, I think so it has just given a lot of courage and voice to the women in the world, I think so, who can talk about anything they've been through, any wrong they've been through, and just come out of it.
I just wanted to know from you that this is the generation that we are living, this is a digital generation that we are living, and there is lots been talk about there has been a lot talking on social media about the clothes, about your skin, about your color, everything. Like there has been a troll community which you get trolled for something or the other. What's your take on that?
I think so. You know, I personally, I just ignore all of that because you cannot take everything so seriously. There, in any time, in any part, in any job you are in, I think so, there will be haters and there will be people who will appreciate you, to elevate you. So I think so, no matter how good you do, no matter how successful you become, no matter how many achievements and validations you have, still there will be people who will somehow skim through just the flaws and the minuses and highlight them and talk about them and troll you. So I think so, any women being bashed on social media for wearing a bikini or wearing a swimsuit, I think so, I don't think so. It's anything that people should even be worried about or even take it to their hearts, because I think so, for a less common fact, like people don't know, swimsuit is an attire.
हम देखते हैं कि सोशल मीडिया पर हमेशा एक ट्रोल कम्युनिटी होती है जो कुछ ना कुछ चीज़ों को लेकर हमेशा ट्रोल करती हैं, खास करके महिलाओं को लेकर, कि उनके अटायर को लेकर, उनके कलर को लेकर, उनके उनके हर चीज़ को लेकर कुछ ना उनको मुद्दा मिल जाता है तो वो ट्रोल कर लेते हैं. तो आप उसे किस तरह से देखते हैं?
आई थिंक सो इट्स जस्ट टू बी इग्नोर्ड एंड लाफ्ड अबाउट. आई थिंक सो नो मैटर हाउ मच यू अचीव इन लाइफ, हाउ मच सक्सेसफुल यू बिकम, हाउ मच गुड यू डू, नो मैटर हाउ ग्रेट यू आर इन व्हाटएवर यू डूइंग एंड हाउ हैप्पी यू feel in whatever space you are in, there will be people, there'll be haters and there'll be people who will appreciate you. So no matter how successful you become, there will still be people who will somehow find just the flaws and the negatives and highlight it and talk about it and troll you. So I think so. Such people should be ignored, because you should obviously you should always take upon just the positivity and optimism of people around you, and people who just want to bash you up for things that you're not even guilty for. I mean, any girl wearing a bikini is being trolled. I don't think so. That's an issue, or that's a problem, or that's anything that's a vice. It is not. Swimsuit is an attire when you go to swim. Obviously, you cannot be wearing jeans or a suit or a burqa when you're going for swimming, right? So I don't think so why it is an issue. But whereas if a guy is wearing his trunks, his swimming trunks, and going for swimming, is standard, is a norm, is normal, is fine. Obviously, he will not wear jeans and get down to a swimming pool, right? So why is it an issue if a girl is wearing a swimsuit and getting down in the pool? So I really don't understand that. So, and any girl being trolled for that, the poor thing, I think she should just ignore it and just be happy in the space she is and just live her life. We stay in a democratic country. We stay in a liberated society. So we should be able to feel liberated and feel free to do whatever we feel like.
Okay. And lastly, just want to know that three things that you want to take a stand on it. And there is a paper beside you, and there is a marker. You have to write the three things that you want to take a stand on.
Take a stand on. Okay. And what could be the third one? I would like to go. I would like to take a stand on Women's Day, like a Dubara, sorry.
Action.
I would like to take a stand for these three bullet points: incapacity of a woman and contributing to the society that we all make. So I think so. I would like to go from down to upwards, from down to up. So my first would be creating a safe world for women. I think so. It is our responsibility to be creating a world that is free of any violence, of any discrimination. Building a society that is safe for us, for our mothers, for our sisters, for our daughters. And we can feel as safe as the men around. Yes, and making a conscious effort by every individual. And taking strict actions, stricter actions for people who have been inculcating in activities like eve teasing, molestation, or sins like rape and all the cases that we've heard, which is unforgettable, and it is not to be forgiven. I think so. So yes, I think so. We all should make a conscious effort in building a society for all of us. And the second would be creating equal opportunities for women. I think so. Women are such a powerhouse of courage, of talent. And they're a reservoir of opportunities. So my second point would be equal opportunities for women. That is the second point. I think so. Women are such a powerhouse of talent, of courage, of sacrifices, and a reservoir of strength. So I think so. We should be given equal opportunities as compared to men, to be able to stand right there and to be able to do as we feel like and contribute to the society not just being restricted to the house or being married and not being able to work. I think so, like I said, we stay in a democratic society and women should be given equal rights and they should feel equally liberated to do as per they feel like. And the first point would be, the third point would be, voice your opinions. I think so, every girl, every woman should be able to talk about their opinions, not suppressed, just because she's a woman, should not be ignored just because she's a woman, or should not be discriminated just because she's a woman. She has an opinion which should be heard of. Thank you.